Now the second one is our courts must. So the recently Honorable Supreme Court judge has made a statement: anti-terror law must not be misused to harass power. This was done by Honorable Justice Chandrachud. So he said that anti-terror law should not be misused to quell dissent or harass citizens. And in an address on Indo-US legal ties, he made a statement that. So he expressed concern that the anti-terror law is being used or rather misused to harass people. That is his concern. So our courts must ensure that they remain the first line of defense against the deprivation of liberty of citizens. So he believes that in the name of the anti-terror law, we are curtailing the freedom, liberty and freedom that is given to guaranteed to the citizens under fundamental rights in the Constitution. So the liberty of the citizens is being tampered with or played with by booking cases of anti-terror law. So this is UAPA, that is. So let us talk about that, how that's going to change. What is anti-terror law? So it is originally enacted in 1967, the UAPA. What is the UAPA? Unlawful Activities Prevention Amendment Bill. So UAPA was amended to be modeled as an anti-terror law in 2004 and 2008. In August 2019, Parliament cleared the unlawful activities to designate individuals as terrorists on certain grounds provided in the Act. So 2019, when we are aware that we discussed this topic earlier too, UAPA as a separate topic. Now in that we said that individuals, what constitute the act of terrorists, acts equal to terrorism, and who are the terrorists have been defined in the act, in the bill. But those grounds and those definitions seem to be too broad and too arbitrary to leave the scope for interpretation or misinterpretation and therefore misuse. That is the concern raised. Between 2016 and 2019, a period which for UAPA figures have been published by the National Crimes Records Bureau, a total of 4,231 FIRs were filed under various sections of the UAPA, of which 112 cases have resulted in convictions. So this is the, so NCRB reports say that how many cases? 4,231 FIRs were filed under various sections, in which only 112 cases have resulted in conviction, which means a large number of cases were on flimsy grounds. When there's a student agitation, they have booked it as under, as you know, the Delhi University case, JNU University case. Recently that has come in the news. In that context, we have discussed earlier about this UAPA, how it is being misused. So settle the political scores, settle the rivalry, settle the old scores and grievances, and frame and fix the adversaries. Also the prominent citizens or activists, whoever are talking against the government or were sounding an element of dissidence, sounding a dissent note against the policies of the government. So such things have been noticed. So the courts have been raising alarm. They said, no, there is a difference between a riot and a terrorism. A riot can be a law and order problem. Terrorism, in fact, is a very serious problem. Both cannot be treated on the same pedestal. So, as you can see, the 4,231 FIRs were filed, but only 112 cases have come under conviction. That clearly shows too many cases were filed on arbitrary grounds to suit somebody's interest or strengthen somebody's political gain or vested political interest. And police have been used, and police should also be very, very careful in booking cases, not to dilute the stringent law of that is the UAPA Amendment Act. So not defined. So the Delhi High Court observed that the court must be careful in employing the definitional words and whether it defines terrorist act. So okay, so this has been discussed already. Terrorist act, it tried to define, it did not define that what is terrorism, but it says what are terrorist acts. So when they are saying there is no, it's too broad and arbitrary and loosely worded, leaving room for misunderstanding, misinterpretation, and even misuse. So the protests are not terror. For example, when JNU students have protested, they were booked under UAPA, means That's why it is saying Delhi Court High Court is making it very clear that protests are not terrorism. The court has highlighted that when the protests turn violent, it will be prima facie, it should be seen as a law and order issue and not as a terrorism. Now, this is the difference. How can we equate both? Law and order is an internal security matter and it is only arising and it is confined to police. You don't bring in the other forces. And it doesn't mean the anti-India or against any organized attack against the territorial integrity or safety and security of the country. It is just a riot. It is just a protest. It is a law and order problem. You can either book them under 144 CRPC or you can book making nuisance, public nuisance. They can be done. Tear gas can be done. Lathi charge perhaps should be done as a last resort. But you cannot book them under terrorism. This is the difference. Criminalizing thoughts. See, the UAPA is so bad that it criminalizes mere thoughts and political protests that cause disaffection with the state. If you are disagreeing with the state, meaning the policies, programs, or any issues related to country, if you are having a difference of opinion also, there is so much of intolerance and people are being booked under these cases. Now, this is the serious problem that need to be curtailed. That is what the Honorable Judge was trying to make it off, make a point. He's saying it is for the courts to act as a defense and also preserve the liberty that is guaranteed in the Constitution to the citizens. So at the flimsy ground, just because somebody criticized the government policy or program, either in the center or state, let us say, it can be both. And so it should not be mere protest, mere dissent, mere difference of opinion, and mere disagreement should not be treated as a criminal act or a criminal intention. So even the thought itself should not be criminalized. Oh, look, he mentioned something, difference of opinion with the state policy or government central policy or central issues. Then somebody spoke in the press, openly criticizing against a certain policy. It should be taken as only a thought, a process, a dissent. Because dissent, right to differ, dissent is at the root of the basic democracy. So it is at the basis of our democracy. So it should be allowed to be expressed. It should not be treated, it should not be criminalized, saying that, oh, you talk something against the policy of the government. After all, democracy means that we have a right to have different opinions. And that's why we have got 5-year election. And then every time we get, perhaps, and sometimes we get the change in governments in different states and center. So that it is a question of, there could be differences of opinion. So they may elect one party to the government. Later, they may elect another party, depending on the difference of ideology. So there's always a scope or room for difference of opinion. They should be accommodated. We should agree to disagree. There should not be a fight to disagree. We should not have any grievance. They should not be treated as disaffection. The word disaffection means spreading hatred. So just because a person, a social activist, a citizen is talking something, criticizing against the government, then it should not be seen as a spreading hatred against that government or with the disaffection with the state. So that is the meaning of the criminalizing thoughts. Then very important, UAPA ignoring fundamental rights. It can simply be used to by UAPA booking the case under UAPA, that is unlawful act prevention. It can be simply used to bypass fundamental rights and procedures. Directly it violates Article 21 of the Constitution, under which citizens are guaranteed fundamental rights, right to life, right to liberty, right to basic rights are being preserved. So that Article 20 of the Constitution is almost like a basic structure that should not be violated. That is the core of the democracy. And that is the core of the spirit of the thesis. If you look at the preamble, Article 21 forms one of the basic articles that guarantee the liberties, right to life. And so therefore, we should be, citizens should be given that fundamental rights. By booking the cases under UAPA, we are directly bypassing these fundamental rights and procedures and violating Article 21. So every time UAPO is booked, for example, 4,326 cases have been booked and only 112 conviction means so many cases have been wrongly booked. And at least half of them are wrongly booked because they did not reach the logical conclusion of getting them punished because they did not stand the scrutiny of the law in the court. They could not win their argument in support of the case. The courts have not satisfied, but therefore not given any conviction in so many cases that have been booked under. So sir, only a fraction of the cases have got conviction means majority of the cases have been not booked for want of evidence, booked or not booked properly under the section, and do not deserve to be coming under the section, and definitely seem to have been booked for various other reasons, but not for the exactly terrorism act, for the scope for which the act has been brought out. So the issue is that protests should not be, earlier protests were treated also a part of terrorism, like in the JNU students case, and criminalizing thought some social activists, some citizens speaking something against the, or some party members of some political party speaking against the government, then immediately there was a booking of the cases against them. So even right to differ, even if we express any disagreement of opinion, or we criticize any policy of the government, it should not be treated as a hatred with the state, disaffection with the state. It should be seen as the only right to differ, and giving a, it's a matter of treated as an opinion. We should tolerate everybody's opinions. Only then, all are not alike. Hence, we are a democratic country. So, there should be scope for constructive criticism. Only then, healthy criticism. And should take that as inputs to improvise the performance, strive towards excellence. But it should not be treated as a disaffection with the state, any criticism as such. So that is the final issue about that. Ignoring fundamental right also is a major issue. And as you can see, the number of cases that are booked and convicted clearly shows fundamental rights have been violated in many cases. Human rights have been also violated in many such cases, and they have been booked and they could not stand the judicial scrutiny and could not be getting conviction because the courts were not satisfied with the evidence that is produced, and also the cases of nature of the cases that have been booked under this do not deserve to be booked under that cases. UAPA is an extreme case. It is an act of, when there is an act of terrorism, the ultimate threat to their national integrity, sovereignty, and territorial integrity, and also the safety and security and the public interest, only then it should be looked upon, but not under the law and order issues or difference of opinion are taken as an effect and a means to say, settle the vendetta or settle the score with the rivals in the by the people who are in the power and so on. So this should be desisted, and we should respect the fundamental rights. So rightly, Honorable Justice Y.V. Chandrachud has are called upon to focus our attention on booking the right cases and also not to misuse this, as it has been put to me a lot of misuse, as shown by the statistics of number of cases booked and also number of this, and it is rightly so. And it is time that the criminal justice system, which include police, judiciary, and all the stakeholders, should take note of this, and they should be more careful in booking these cases. There can be political directions, but they should look at the suitability of the case and examine and give it. Now the third one. So why in news, actually, this is before we go to the third one, we'll talk about this. Why it is in news, anti-terror law should not be misused to quell dissent or harass citizens. This is being done now. Anybody disagrees with it, which I mentioned now, the Supreme Court is a counter-majoritarian institution sworn to protect the rights of socio-economic minorities. See, what is happening is, any person who is criticizing is considered to be minority. So therefore, he is being singled out and targeted. That group is targeted and attacked, and the cases are booked against them. So Supreme Court should serve as a protector mechanism, as a protection institution, to protect the rights of such socioeconomic minorities who are having some dissent, and say therefore should not be harassed. Many such cases of constitutional violence are found in their way to the Supreme Court. And that's how Honorable Justice has noted in his observation while he was speaking at this US TICE meeting. As the guardian of the Constitution, the Supreme Court had to put a brake when executive or legislation actions infringed fundamental human rights. So the Supreme Court has this very important function that it can see that there is a gross violation of fundamental rights, and therefore there's a need to put a brake on as a guardian of the Constitution. He has, Honorable Judge has, Justice has called upon to put a brake so that we can ensure that the legislative actions don't infringe the fundamental human rights, and such UAPA passing of the such legislations do not interfere with the fundamental rights. What is the way forward? A strong anti-terrorism law is needed in India. Of course it is needed, and it should be only meant for terrorism, not for difference of opinion or a dissent or disagreeing with the government or criticizing government, or because the freedom of expression is there in democracy. So if a person is criticizing, you cannot say when you talk only you should talk right, a positive thing, or only appreciation but not criticism. There is no such thing like that. Democracy accommodates both criticism and also appreciations. So you cannot say we will punish you if you talk something negative, which means if you criticize, but we will not punish you if you appreciate. You cannot, that is not called freedom of speech. So the existing UAPA does have some defects and demerits which we mentioned. The wording is not correct, definition is not correct. So many times when it has come before the court, different courts, high courts and also Supreme Court, Honorable Supreme Court had made a very strong observation that all these cases, definitions are not properly given, and the cases have not been rightly filed under the provisions, right provisions, and the cases that have been filed do not come under UAPA at all. The Act needs to be amended in order to ensure a constitutional functionary. Okay, so that is the very important thing. So we need to amend. Terrorism and unlawful activities are the ones that always create political issues. If the Act has to work, its application must at all times look apolitical. So it should not look like a political weapon by the ruling governments or the governments in power to strike against the citizens or activists or anybody who is trying to make a difference of opinion or having a difference of opinion. So it should not be used as a political weapon or a political tool. It should be totally apolitical and purely on the merits of the case, which means whether it is a terrorism act or not should be looked into. And in that case, there is nothing political, because terrorism has no religion, no loyalty, no politics, no basis, and no favoritism. Terrorism doesn't deserve to be having any kind of loyalty or terrorism, favoritism. It should be punished, and anti-terrorism laws should take note of that. And the anti-terrorism laws should only be used for such deserving cases and should not be used as a political weapon. Thank you.